Today I'm going to share what variance or print jog means, what safety trim and bleed are, and how to confirm these specifications in InDesign, Affinity, and Acrobat Pro. We'll review where these options appear in either the document setup, export settings, or properties. First, it's good to understand variance. Variances are small shifts in color and finishing in printing and manufacturing processes. Variances within a pretty small range aren't mistakes. They are the unintended result of automation. Manufacturing automation means that at each point in the production process, the same focused action is being repeated endlessly by the same machine running at a really high speed. So the inaccuracy of how an offset or a digital printer automatically grabs and feeds in paper, or the not quite exact cut at the print shop's giant stack paper cutter, through many different factors, you should expect the possibility of some minor imprecisions in any form of automated manufacturing. That said, as the producer of your own content, it's something you would notice as you know your own intent, but it's not necessarily something a consumer of your product might notice, as they're probably only seeing that one item. This is especially true with large print runs of the same content. If you pulled one of the first and one of the last items printed and compared them side by side, you would no doubt see a little bit of variance. So your goal is to minimize that noticeability of those differences, and the best way to do that is to mind your safety area and your bleed in relation to your paper trim. Safety is the valuable page space for your content. This is the largest area in your document, and it's surrounded by a margin space, just like you would have in a word processing program. What goes in this space is all of your text and all of your visual elements that are not supposed to get cut off. This includes repeating page elements like chapter headers and footers and page numbers and any supporting spot art for these elements. Our minimum recommended margin space is 1/4 inch on all four sides for books and 1/8 inch on all four sides for playing cards. Trim is the page or the card edge, the line where the paper gets cut down by a blade. It's really important that you've kept your safety area elements away from this line with that nice cushy margin space in between because of the variance that we just talked about. Although it's common practice to dictate where this line is in your document by adding crop marks to your file export, in the printing workflow that we have, we require files without these marks. And finally, bleed. Bleed is that page area outside of your trim line. This is the extra area that gets discarded after printing. You would use this space for any elements that would visually run off the page, like a background paper texture or a full page illustration. Our current specs call for 1/8 inch of bleed space outside the trim. If you're producing a card deck, that required bleed is on all four sides of the card. If you're producing a book, that bleed space is only on 3 of the 4 page edges, the top, the bottom, and the outside. The inside page edge, that's the gutter. That's where the book gets glued and bound. And because of this, it does not require additional bleed space. Now that we've discussed what safety, trim, and bleed mean in terms of layout and variance, let's look at this in action. Here's a playing card built to the correct specifications. This is the trim line. This is the outer boundary of the safety area with the minimum 1/8 inch margin space to the trim. And this is the 1/8 inch bleed on all four sides. As you can see, despite the print jog, or variance, from card to card, everything important inside the safety area remains inside the final trim. The bleed space outside the final trim line ensures that the background art runs to the edge of the card rather than ending somewhere on the page. Without that bleed and due to the variance, you would see a blank white space where the art ends instead. Here's a card, not built to the correct specs. In this instance, the card layout didn't allow enough of a margin space for critical visual information. And as a result, you can see that those elements interfere with the trim line. The space between those elements and the paper edge is either too tight or would get cut out entirely. Although this demonstration is of a playing card, which has a recommended safety margin of 1/8 of an inch, the same principle applies to books, although that safety margin is much wider, at a minimum of 1/4 inch. Starting a fresh document in InDesign, open a new document intended for print and enter your card or book trim size. In the new document dialog box, you'll be able to also assign values for your margin size and bleed space. To assign unequal values to the margin or bleed, toggle off the chain link button on the side. After you've chosen your appropriate values, click OK to accept them. If you navigate up to your master pages, you can see the guides in place at those values. You can also navigate up to the drop-down menu to find layout and then navigate to margins and columns to confirm or change your safety margin settings. If you already have a working document, navigating to layout and then margins still applies, but you can also go directly to your document setup under the file pull-down menu to confirm or update trim, bleed, and margin sizes. You can also navigate to view, screen mode, and then preview to screen proof what your project looks like at trim size without the additional bleed. Starting a fresh document in Affinity Publisher, open a new document from the file pull-down menu. The new document dialog box will open and have fields that you can fill out to assign values for your trim, bleed, and margin spaces. If you already have a working document, navigate to the file pull-down menu and then select Document Setup. There, you'll be able to confirm or change your trim, bleed, and margin spaces. To confirm your bleed size in Acrobat Pro, open your PDF file and then navigate to Properties from the File drop-down menu. In the Documents Description tab, you will be able to see basic information about the file's metadata and the physical page size of the document. If this number doesn't match whatever the value is of your trim size plus the additional bleed space, then you should back up a step and confirm both your document setup information and your final PDF export settings in your original layout program.